COVID-19 from the Africa CDC. The director of the Africa CDC, Dr. John Nkengasong, is with us as usual. And today he is joined by Her Excellency Jessie LaPenne, who is the head of the United States mission to the African Union. Now, Ambassador LaPenne is joining us to share more information regarding the deliveries of U.S. vaccine donations, which began last week throughout the African continent. And she will also highlight the USAU mission's partnership with the Africa CDC in the fight against COVID. And then we will also be joined by Mr. Strive Masiwa, and he is the African Union's special envoy on COVID-19 and is also the coordinator of the African Vaccine Acquisition Task Force, AVAT. And he will be joining us today to update us on vaccine acquisition and distribution throughout the continent. Today, we are coming to you in English and French. And when we come to our question and answer section, please send your questions to +251 94 550 2310. And that will be on WhatsApp. You can also come in live or utilize the question and answer section. All right, now let's get into our briefing from Dr. John. Dr. John, good morning, and you have the floor.
Thank you, Wayne. Greetings, a very warm welcome and greetings from the African Union Commission headquarters and Africa CDC. At this time, I would like to share with you updates on the COVID-19 situation on the continent. And as usual, I'll divide my remarks into three. First of all, look at the epidemiological situation, and then discuss what Africa CDC is currently doing to support member states to fight the third wave, and then focus on the vaccine and vaccination situation on the continent. Let me join Wayne in welcoming Ambassador Jessie LaPenne, who has been a very strong advocate and supporter of Africa CDC's efforts since this pandemic started. And we'll have an opportunity during this very important session to discuss more. As Wayne mentioned, Mr. Masiwa, Strive Masiwa, will be joining us shortly to discuss and announce to you all some very interesting updates, good progress with respect to vaccine delivery from AVAT. So let's start with the epidemiological situation. As of this morning, 9 a.m. East African time, about 6.3 million cases of COVID have been reported across all 55 member states. And this accounts for 3% of the total cases reported globally. Of this number, unfortunately, 160,000 individuals have died, and this represents a case fatality ratio of 2.5%. Five countries are accounting for over 63% of total cases across the continent. They include South Africa with 37%, Morocco 9%, Tunisia 9%, Egypt and Ethiopia 4% each. There are four countries that have a case fatality rate of about 5%. They include Egypt, Sahrawi Republic, Somalia, and Sudan. Again, as I indicated earlier, we are in the middle of a third wave across the continent. And as we speak, 53% of our member states, that is 29 countries, are experiencing a severe third wave. And of that, 20 countries are experiencing a more aggressive third wave than previously when what we observed with the second wave. Since the last time we briefed, six additional countries are now reporting a third wave. They include Gambia, Guinea-Bissau, Lesotho, Libya, Mauritania, and Morocco. Two countries are actually experiencing a fourth wave. That is Algeria and Tunisia. With respect to the variants of concern, 38 countries out of the 55 member states are now reporting the Alpha variant. 3 additional new member states have now reported since last week the Alpha variant, and these include Benin, Chad, and Namibia. 32 countries are now reporting the Beta variant, and these include, and we have a long list of those, and 21 countries are reporting the Delta variant. And one additional country, that is Namibia, has now reported the Delta variant since the last time we briefed. And you can go to our website at www.africacdc.org and pathogen genomics to see an update of where all the variants that have been reported are. So let us now look at the changes in the epidemiological situation with respect to, first of all, the 1 week interval since last Thursday to now, and then we'll look at 4 weeks. So over the last, what we call the epidemiological week of 28, this is this week, and compare that with last week, a total of 281 new cases have been reported across the continent, and that represents a 3% decrease over the last week. And the highest proportion of these new cases are reported are coming from Southern Africa with 57%, North Africa 32%, East Africa 6%, West Africa 4%, and Central Africa 1%. The following 6 countries are reporting the highest daily incident per million population, include Seychelles, Botswana, Tunisia, Libya, and Namibia. In terms of the new deaths, a total of 6,161 new deaths were reported across the continent over the reporting period, compared to 5,492 from the previous week. And this represents a 12% increase in the number of new deaths compared to last week. Now, if you now look at the 4 weeks period, that is over a period between 21st of June and 18th of July, we observed that a total of 16% average increase in new cases have occurred across the continent, with the highest numbers being reported in West Africa with 41%, 36% in North Africa, 12% increase in Southern Africa, 1% increase in East Africa, and a 2% decrease in Central Africa. If you look at it, break it down by the most populous countries, Nigeria leads the way with an increase of 64%, South Africa 10%, Kenya 4%, with decreases in Egypt, Ethiopia, and DRC. However, the death rates over the last 4 weeks has been a 21% average increase, okay, over that period of time. In terms of testing, as a continent, a total of 57 million COVID tests have been conducted. And last week alone, a total of about 1.4 million tests were conducted. And that represents a 6% increase when you compare this to the previous week. Unfortunately, the case positivity rate remains high at around 11%. We want to see countries reporting about 5% or less, but overall average is around 11% as we speak. 25% of our member states or 14 countries are reporting test positivity rates of 12%. We can discuss that later. So what are we doing in the midst of this Africa CDC to support countries to address the third wave? What we are doing is dispatching what we call the SWAP teams, the SWAT teams, which is a military term borrowed from the military term, which is a deployment strategy that you go in tactically and with commodities and responders and to support countries to fight the third wave, and then you move to another country. So that strategy has enabled us to be deployed in Seychelles, Zambia, Cameroon, Sierra Leone, and Namibia, and we'll continue to rotate. So we go in with smaller teams, recruit in-country about 500 to 1,000 responders, fight where the hotspots are, then we move the team to another country. I think we'll continue to roll that until we bring down. Our goal is to bring down bend the curve as quickly as possible so that it can relieve the health system, the burden on the health systems, as you have been reading on the news. So let me just conclude on the vaccine and really just give you high level information as you hear more from our two participants. As of today, the continent has acquired 82.7 million COVID vaccine doses amongst 51 member states. Of that number, 61.3 million doses have been administered, and that represents about 74%. In other words, our doses are not being wasted. That is, up to about 75% of the doses have been used. And if you look at those in the individuals that have actually received the full coverage, that accounts for about 1.3% of the population. That is the full immunization. Just some numbers to substantiate that. Morocco has used up about 80% of its supplies. South Africa has used up about 64% of its supplies. Egypt, about 68% of all its supplies. Nigeria, 99.97% of its supplies. And Algeria, 68% of all its supplies. And more of that information can actually be seen on our website. Three countries are yet to start vaccination, that is Tanzania, Eritrea, and Burundi. At this point, I would like to give you and to conclude some updates on some recent developments. You heard yesterday that Pfizer and BioNTech and the South African BioVac Institute will start working together to produce or manufacture about 100 million doses of vaccines over 2022. That will be essentially the fill and finish, similar to what the Aspen is doing with the Johnson & Johnson. You also heard that on July the 15th, Germany was donating 30 million doses of vaccines across the world. But very importantly, 21 million doses of vaccines are being shipped out of the US donation that has started in 49 countries. And that include the Johnson & Johnson doses, the Moderna, the Pfizer. 1 million of that donation will be made more bilaterally. And you have a chance to hear more from Ambassador Le Pen. So thank you for the opportunity. As always, I look forward to an exciting conversation. And Wayne, over to you.
Thank you very much, John. It's now time to introduce Her Excellency Jessie Le Pen, after whom we will be hearing from Mr. Strive Masiwa. So Ambassador Le Pen is the head of the US mission to the African Union, as I stated earlier, and she's here to share with us information regarding the delivery of the US vaccine donations throughout the continent, as well as to update us on the nature of the partnership that the USAU has with the African Union and with the Africa CDC in fighting COVID-19. Ambassador, a very good morning to you, and you have the floor.
Good morning, thanks. Thanks so much. I'm sure many of our media colleagues have been tracking, and as Dr. John indicated, the US is now delivering COVID-19 vaccines across the continent. So this week, we have already delivered about 1 million doses of Johnson & Johnson to Burkina
Faso. Ambassador, excuse me. Can I ask you to switch on your video?
It's on.
All right.
It should be on, and it shows as recording.
Yeah. Right.
Thank you.
Sure. So for this week, we've done about 1 million vaccines of the J&J that have gone to Burkina Faso, Djibouti, Ethiopia, the Gambia, and Senegal. There'll be another 1.2 million doses this week to Cameroon, Lesotho, Niger, Zambia, and Central African Republic. So these deliveries are the first tranche of approximately 25 million COVID-19 vaccine doses being donated to Africa. That's out of 80 million doses that the Biden administration announced for global donations last month. So in the next coming weeks, we'll continue to see additional deliveries to reach this 25 million. Crucially, we expect these shipments to be the first of many as U.S. government contributes to the AU target of vaccinating at least 60% across the continent. U.S. government and Africa CDC worked closely together to coordinate on allocation of these vaccine donations. Specifically, we coordinated with Dr. John and with Strive and with others on the AU's Africa Vaccine Acquisition Task Team, or AVAT, which we'll hear more about. For us, the decision to collaborate in this way was significant. I think it reflects how impressed we've been with Africa CDC and with the AU's continent-wide coordination efforts. So AU leadership in the continent's response has been consistent from the outset of the pandemic, mobilizing health ministers, establishing a procurement platform, and coordinating the continental strategy. In the first waves of the pandemic, we saw the AU had a very well-coordinated and effective response, including specifically in supply chain management. More recently, it's developed a continent-wide vaccination plan, so it was a natural partner on the allocation of vaccines. For us at the U.S. Mission to the AU, or USAU, this partnership is basically what we've been doing since the establishment of Africa CDC. Our comprehensive approach includes technical assistance from the U.S. Centers for Disease Control, as well as programs with USAID and other government agencies. And in this forum, I really want to acknowledge the strength of the USAU partnership and thank Dr. John for his efforts to make this partnership significant and to make these deliveries possible. In addition to these ongoing vaccine deliveries, the US will also donate an additional 500 million Pfizer vaccine doses globally starting in August, as President Biden committed just before the G7. And these vaccines will also be delivered to Africa and other around the world through COVAX. On COVAX, the US is the largest single contributor, having provided $2 billion in March to support procurement and equitable distribution of vaccines around the world. In addition to working with US vaccine manufacturers to increase vaccine supply, we're also working to expand vaccine production in Africa. So the DFC, or the US International Development Finance Corporation, announced on June 30 the US contribution to a $700 million loan being made to expand Aspen Pharma in South Africa. And we've recently signed an agreement with Senegal and other partners for production of COVID-19 vaccines in Senegal. These commitments are really part and parcel of the US historic leadership on humanitarian and health assistance across the continent, including our support to combat COVID-19. Since the outbreak of the pandemic, the US has provided roughly $541 million in health, humanitarian, and economic support assistance to sub-Saharan Africa for COVID response. This follows a roughly $100 billion worth of investment in Africa's public health over the last two decades. These investments have contributed to health systems that have helped partner countries to meet the challenges of COVID-19. US contributions to Africa CDC crucially haven't been limited though to the US government. US foundations and private companies have also contributed significantly with funds, technical assistance, and commercial solutions, demonstrating that our country's commitment to being a vital health partner to the continent isn't just a priority of government. It's also not just US companies and foundations, and we applaud the recent announcement by the Canada-based MasterCard Foundation of a $1.3 billion contribution to partner with Africa CDC and to help make critical progress to provide COVID vaccines across the continent. We welcome and encourage such support. As Dr. John and others have said repeatedly, none of us is safe until all of us are safe. So as the situation around the globe and on the continent continues to evolve, so does our response. We'll continue to share vaccines from our supply, work with partners around the world, including the African Union and Africa CDC, to get ahead of the virus, follow the science, and support countries in crisis. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. That was Ambassador Jessie LaPen, who is the head of the U.S. mission to the African Union. We now move on and welcome Mr. Strive Masiwa, who is the African Union Special Envoy on COVID-19 and is also the coordinator of the African Vaccine Acquisition Task Force, AVAT. And Mr. Masiwa is here to update us on vaccine acquisition and distribution around the continent. Good morning, Mr. Masiwa, and you have the floor.
Good morning. Let me start with just reminding you of our objectives and what we want to achieve. The African Union leadership in August decided that a minimum of 60% of our population must be vaccinated. That amounts to roughly 780 million people out of the 1.3 billion. In addition, the African Union leadership entered into an agreement with the CARICOM countries that they would be part of our joint procurement structures. They have been working with